72. 6 hours and not 24. A new rule by the international governing body, FIA, shortened the race in order to meet the requirements of adding a new, smaller engine size. Ferrari entered three of the smaller engine 3-liter cars, and Mario Andretti won the car he shared with Jackie Hicks on the pole. Despite losing a cylinder early in the event, the Andretti Hicks car was steady throughout, and as other racers had issues, it moved to the lead and would stay there to give Ferrari first and second in the newly shortened event. 50 years of champions, 1973. He returned to the 24-hour format this year. Also, I think the trend to more street-looking cars, but looking street didn't mean slow, as the cars of Stuttgart would show taillights to the favored prototypes. Horses fielded by Brumos Racing and Roger Penske battled for the lead as the first place Matra dropped out just after midnight. By 5:30 in the morning, the Brumos entry, driven by Peter Gregg and Curly Hayden, had managed a 35-lap lead over the field. Their final margin was 22 laps over the second place Ferrari and Curly Hayden and Gregg's first win. 50 years of champions, 1975, and back from a one-year hiatus due to the 1974 international fuel crisis, street-based cars were once again the norm in 1975 as a Chevrolet Corvette, driven by John Greenwood, sat on the pole. But that didn't mean that the field of BMWs, Ferraris, and Porsches would make life easy on a sports car out of Detroit. Greenwood would lead from the start, but retired after a series of mechanical failures and then wreck, which put him out of place and out of contention for the win. Subsequently, he went to Dan Elliott, led the Porsche of Al Holbert and Elliott Ford Robinson. But the Brumos team of Gregg and Hayden would once again persevere, passing for the lead for good just after dawn to capture their second straight Rolex 24. 50 years of champions, 1976. Charlie Hayden and Peter Gregg came for the 1976 race, each with two wins in a row. This year, with Gregg in a BMW and Hayden in a Porsche, only one could make him three straight victories. Gregg started the pole-winning BMW, and the car ran into the night with the lead. During his night shift, though, Gregg fell ill, and co-driver Brian Redman pulled a double stint. And Jonathan Patrick, driving another BMW, was brought over to fill in for the ailing Gregg for the remainder of the event. A mysterious issue of water in the fuel of many of the competitors, including the lead BMW, stopped the race for almost 3 hours as the problem was solved. The race continued, and Peter Gregg became the first driver to win three consecutive runnings of the famed sports car race here at Daytona. 50 years of champions, 1978. Horses with turbos were in full force this year. Danny Ongais put a 935 turbo on the pole for the race, and when the green flag dropped, stayed planted at the front for the first 8 laps. The Kramer Brothers 935 assumed the lead from Ongais, but parked with a failed turbo on lap 86. The next horse in a step up to the lead would stay there. Drivers Rolf Stommelen, Antoine Hesmans, and Peter Gregg came just shy of the race record speed and led 667 of 680 laps. 50 years of champions, 1980. Porsche. The dominant entry in 1980 came with several models, including the powerful 935Ks, which sat on the pole with a record speed of 132.782 miles per hour. it really did seem like a year in which the question was, which Porsche show would win? It wasn't the pole-sitting car of the Whittington brothers. It would be the Reinhold Ghost Fielded car, driven by the car owner, Paul Solomon, and Volker Barrel as co-driver. The lead was exchanged with the Whittington brothers for most of the race, but when that car closed Sunday morning, it was the ghost car all the way to the checkers. 50 years of champions. 1962. The first Rolex 24 at Daytona was actually the 3-hour Daytona Continental. And yes, they used to run to the car at the green flag. American Dan Gurney pulled to the head of the pack, opening up a full lap lead on the field. With a failing motor and less than 2 minutes to go, he stopped 5 feet short of the finish line. And as the clock ran out, he coasted across the line to become the first of 49 winners of the now famous endurance race. 50 years of champions. 1963. Mexican brothers Pedro and Ricardo Rodriguez competed in the inaugural Daytona Continental, with Ricardo finishing second. After the death of his brother in the fall, Pedro had second thoughts about competing in the 1963 Continental. But compete he did, and took control early in the race, driving the then new Ferrari 215 GTO. Quick pit stop for fuel and a driver change kept the team in the lead throughout most of the event. Despite a late, unscheduled pit stop for fuel, Rodriguez's Ferrari finished 64 seconds ahead of runner-up and fellow Ferrari driver Roger Penske. 50 years of champions. 1964. In a step toward a 24-hour event, the 1964 Continental was lengthened from 3 hours to 2,000 kilometers. This year was gearing up as a Ford versus Ferrari battle, as eight Shelby Cobras were entered, including a new Daytona. The Daytona owned the opening 8 hours, but a fire from an oil leak put the car behind the wall during a pit stop. That put Ferrari of Pedro Rodriguez and American Phil Hill into the lead, where they would stay to win. Ferrari would sweep the top three podium spots, with the top finishing Cobra coming home in fourth. 50 years of champions. 1965. The Cobra's lack of success in 1964 didn't deter Ford from coming at Ferrari with a vengeance in 1965. This year, the new GT40 rolled into Daytona with the boys from Maranello in its sights. Despite sticking with the GT40s and Cobras early, the Ferraris were no match for the Detroiter. The GT40 of Kent Miles and Lloyd Ruby would benefit from the engine trouble of the Dan Gurney, Jerry Grant Lotus to take the lead and finish 5 laps ahead of the runner-up Shelby Daytona Coupe. Ford Power took the top 4 spots that year. 50 years of champions. 1966. For the first time, the Daytona race would run 24 hours, and fans would also see the continuing battle of Ford and Ferrari for sports car dominance. In a race that would start in the warm sunshine, the GT40 of Kent Miles and Roy Ruby quickly took the lead. Overnight temperatures in the freezing range made the challenge a bit more interesting for the teams than in past years, and the lead of Miles and Ruby was a lead they would never relinquish. The Miles Ruby GT40 was going on the podium by his brother GT40s with a Ferrari in fourth. 50 years of champions. 1967. Ferrari eats losing and showed up at Daytona in 1967 with one goal: beat Ford and the GT40s. Jim Hall's unique chaparral jumped out to the early lead, but retired after 3.5 hours due to crash damage. 6 hours in, Ferrari ran 1-3-6. The GT40 Mountain Challenge. From B4, Chris Amon and Lorenzo Bandini, led the Ferrari sweep of the top three spots, with Porsche having its best showing ever at Daytona in fourth with a 9-10. Wanted a repeat of the sweep Porsche had pulled off in 1968. Ford was back with GT40s, and Lola entered the fray with five T70s. The Roger Penske entry driven